Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 18. Today I'll be showcasing a photo that I took while on a photo safari in my own house. The day was pouring rain, but I had the opportunity to try out a new camera that I had borrowed from a friend, and I was itching to use it. In shooting this book, I tried many different angles, settings, and backdrops, and I ultimately ended up using black cutting boards to create the surrounding space. You know, anything in a pinch, right? Which worked pretty well, but needed cleanup in post-processing, as did a few other simple things like exposure, contrast, saturation, and shadows. Just FYI, I shot this with a Nikon D7000 on a tripod using a fast lens, a 35mm f1.8 lens, 30-second shutter speed, at f22 and an ISO of 640. Now, normally I begin by adjusting exposure, and don't ask me why. With this photo, I decided to go into the HSL tab and change the saturation, the color space first. I'm still learning Lightroom. My methods sometimes may not be as prescribed as they should be in the order in which Lightroom would like me to proceed, but I have fun, and in the end I end up with a result that I like. So I will show you my strange out of order procedure that I used for this photo. So I went into the HSL tab, and I'm going to open that panel and scroll down, and I'm going to go into the saturation and adjustment, and I'm going to click on the targeted adjustment tool, and I want to change the color of the pages to white, basically. So the targeted adjustment tool, or TAT, I will click and hold my mouse and I will drag. If I drag up, it will saturate it more, but I'm looking to desaturate, so I'm going to pull it down. And you'll see, if you look at the sliders on the right, that there are orange and yellow in the book, in the pages. So it targets the colors that are in the portion of the photograph that you place the tool over, which makes it very handy, so there's no guessing. So I'm going to continue to pull this down pretty far. And I'm just looking at my notes and trying to get it to where my original photo was. And I'm going to pull this over because in my original photo, and I must have targeted a different section, these were my original settings. So I'm going to leave that there. And then I'm going to come back and I'm going to, okay, here I said it's a bit strange, but I am going to move the white slider. You can see from the histogram that I have not set a white point, so I'm going to take my white slider and I am going to move it up, which also, of course, increases the exposure. So right there, it's about 83, which is before the clipping occurs, and I like that. And now it's very bright. So I'm going to come into my exposure slider and I'm going to pull that exposure down to about there. I'm looking at my notes, and then I'm going to come into the shadows. Now this is, I like what the color of the book and the pages, but what I need to take care of is this surface of the cutting board to get rid of that. So quick little tip, I pull down my shadows all the way, and you'll see that it will darken around the book even more. So I like that effect even up top, a great contrast between the pages and the blackness. It doesn't get rid of all of it, however, so I am going to come into, and I don't want to pull the blacks down anymore because they're clipped, as they would be because it's very dark, but I'm going to try a different method to get rid of this area down here, and that would be using the graduated filter. So I'm going to click on the graduated filter, and I'm going to bring my icon, mouse, cursor marker. I'm at a loss for words as to what to call this at the moment. And I'm going to hold, and I'm going to click and drag to place the graduated filter. Now here's something I want to do it parallel. I'm trying to get it parallel to the spine of the book. And to rotate, I can rotate the filter. And it's much easier to control it when you rotate out here. If I try to rotate it here, it moves very fast. So always come out here and click on your mouse, and you can adjust it more easily. Now I'm going to pull this up a bit, and I'm going to pull this down a bit, make it a little bit smaller, and I'm going to move the entire thing up. And then I'm going to come over and I'm going to play with the exposure, which is already set at minus 29, which is what I had used in my original photo. I'm going to pull it down a bit more to 133. And then I'm going to click done. And the last thing, being compulsive that I am, there's two little spots here in the spine that I would like to get rid of with the spot removal tool. So I'm going to open this panel back up, and I'm going to come back into my navigator, and I'm going to pull up at, well, let's see, I'm going to do the 2:1 and bring this box over here. 1:1 may be just fine, and find the spots. Here's the spot removal tool. I'm going to bring it over, and I'm just going to paint over the spots, and Lightroom will find an appropriate replacement. And if I like it, then I just click done, and you'll see those spots are gone. I'm coming out to the fit panel, and there you go. I want to look back to see in my detail panel, yes, just so that you know, when I import my pictures into Lightroom, I have a preset and a sharpening preset, which was applied already. It's sharpening raw scenic. And these are my settings. You can see I increased the sharpening amount to 60 and the other levels here. So this has already been applied. The last thing that I typically always do in my photos is apply a post-crop vignette. This is not needed here. So this is the one instance where I am not going to use that. This is now a finished photograph, and I will show you. I will go back to the original. Let me go back in history. There's the before, and there's the after. And I did convert this photo into black and white and post it on Monochromia, that will publish later this afternoon, on Friday. But I really, really like the touch of red in here. So it was a hard decision whether to go completely black and white or red. Actually, it was a slightly different perspective, a slightly different photo. So if you're curious, go have a look at it. I will put the link in the post. So that's it. I hope you've enjoyed the video this week. It was simple process, but you can see that I accomplished a lot, even using a black cutting board as a backdrop. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments section. And if you're watching this on YouTube to see more post-processing videos and galleries of after-before photos, please visit visualventuring.com and select After Before Friday Forum in the menu. Thanks for watching.